An ellipse is very similar to a circle, however, it has a major axis and it has a minor axis for its radius. So I sometimes call it an X radius and a Y radius, or a major radius and a minor radius. Now, they can appear to open horizontally, or not quite open horizontally, but lay horizontally, and then they can also appear to be vertically, where the major axis is horizontal, or the major axis is vertical. We'll talk first about the horizontal axis being the major axis. We have an equation in its general form, x minus h quantity squared all over a squared plus y minus k quantity squared all over b squared equals 1. Now this part's really important, the fact that it's equal to 1. Must be equal to 1. The center is going to be h comma k. And the center is going to be, in this case, right here at the origin. The major axis is going to be, in this case, along the horizontal axis, which is the x-axis. So it's going to have a major radius of A. So the major axis, in this case, is along the x-axis. And the x-radius, which is what I will call it, the x-radius is equal to A. The minor axis is going to be on the vertical axis for this particular ellipse. So the minor axis is along the y-axis. And I like to call that the y-radius. The y-radius in this case is B. And in this case, A is going to be greater than B. So A will be greater than B. The foci, there's going to be two foci, and the foci are going to always be along the major axis. So they will always be along the major axis, or on the major axis, and they will be a distance C, which is equal to C from, I should say, from H comma K, equal to the square root of A squared minus B squared. Now, if we happen to be vertically long, then your A, which is going to be greater than B, is going to be the denominator for the y variable. So again, here we're going to have A is greater than B. The center is still going to be at h comma k. So the center will still be at h comma k. H comma k. And the major axis, this time the major axis is going to be along the y-axis. And that's why it's going to be stretched vertically. And I'll call that a y-radius equal to A still. And then the minor axis, in this case, will be along the x-axis. It'll be horizontally. And I'll call that x radius, which is equal to b. And then again, the foci is still the same value. It's a distance away from the center. Now, when the major and the minor axes are equal, so if I have, let me draw a nice little picture for you. If I have a major axis and a minor axis equal, what do you think that's going to look like? Yep, that looks like a circle. So when the major and the minor axes are equal, we have got a circle. So what we'll do next is we will start working with some actual equations so that we can put numbers to this and make sense of what this is all about.